terms of racism and football, do you feel that racism has been a taboo subject within football culture and football circles?
I think rather than a taboo subject, I think the problem with racism for the game in general is that the game has initially felt uncomfortable about even acknowledging racism. Rather, it's felt uncomfortable about acknowledging that it exists at all in the game. And that was certainly the case here. You know, they would try and brush it under the carpet or say it wasn't anything to do with the game. It was just these people, these hooligans who'd brought it in, and that's a police matter. Gradually, the clubs have begun to realise, the clubs and the football administrators had begun to realise that actually hooliganism isn't very good for the game itself and its image. I think that's part of why there is this public concern now with racism, because the game has this rather airbrushed image, this glossy, successful, commercially attractive image of itself, and racism doesn't fit very well with that. You know, it doesn't fit very well with consumers and customers. So racism has to be dealt with. And so that's one of the reasons I think why the game is more aware and more alert and more willing to be seen to be acting against racism. But another bigger danger is that the game also likes this idea that we know who the racists are. And it's easy to identify racists. You know, they're skinheads. They're people with swastikas on their heads. They're these hooligans that everyone keeps on talking about. And therefore, once you deal with that and identify and exclude those racists, then racism will disappear. That racism is something that other people do, and we all know who they are. And what that means is that the kind of institutional racism within the game itself doesn't get dealt with. It's still there, and it's still kind of accepted as the way in which clubs do their normal business. And so now, you know, academics and others are beginning to say, let's disconnect this idea that racism is just hooliganism is in another form. Let's look much more seriously about who you're employing or what your policies are with in terms of recruiting, you know, other kinds of staff. Or are you exhibiting racism in terms of recruiting players, or in terms of what happens in the boardroom? And I think that, you know, that will be the new battleground about race and racism, opening up clubs for investigation on this, because football clubs are extremely important symbolizers of local forms of community and representation, and in some places I think clubs have been very comfortable with the idea that they think themselves as good community clubs. But I think about it in terms of those old traditions that we've been talking about earlier, this old rootedness, this old form of identification with the past and with tradition and who we are. And they haven't realised or recognised that actually ideas about community have changed, and the people who make up local communities have changed. And the clubs somehow have to reorient themselves to make themselves more attractive and more open to new kinds of communities. I don't think anywhere near enough thought or action has gone into that. So I think in some places, clubs, and this doesn't just occur in Britain, it occurs all over the world, clubs still appeal to very closed and exclusive kinds of communities, which are often built around ethnic enmities and forms of ethnic exclusion. And I think it's interesting that in some places in this country, in England certainly, the local football clubs are strongly identified with traditional white forms of community identification. And they're actually still seen by long-established ethnic minority communities as exclusive forums, as dangerous places, as places that they don't belong. They're not included in this sense of community. So I think that will be where the focus will turn next, and away from this simple identification of hooligan fans with overt racism, which to some extent, at least in England, not in other parts of the world perhaps to the same extent, but in some places that overt expression of racism has been confronted and is being dealt with.